Hello guys from the Nizhny Novgorod, the fifth largest city in Russia. I would call it the second tier city of Russia. Like in China, they have system of tiers. And I'm now in the outskirts of Nizhny Novgorod, but even here you can find some interesting sightings like this tank T-34, the weapon of the victory, in just a simple panel neighborhood, Soviet neighborhood. And even buildings here are covered in the beautiful paintings. But there are also some half-govniks here still. People walk with beer at night, like in St. Petersburg 15-20 years ago. But in general, it's quite safe neighborhood. But let me show you the beautiful part, the historical part of the city. Let's go. Nizhny Novgorod population is bigger than 1 million people, and I would call this kind of cities the second tier cities of Russia. You know, in China they have like this system of tiers, like first tier cities like Beijing, Shanghai, second tier cities, and like third, fourth. And in Russia we have two biggest cities, Moscow and St. Petersburg. They are so-called cities of the federal importance. And since 2014, Sevastopol also the city of the federal importance. But you know, Sevastopol is not comparable with Moscow and St. Petersburg. So those cities, Moscow and St. Petersburg, they are separate. They have their number, own number plates and so on. But this kind of city as Nizhny Novgorod has more than 1 million people. And we have like around 15 cities like that. So let's see how it looks like compared to the biggest cities like Moscow, my previous video, and my hometown St. Petersburg. Will be there a big difference or no? That's guys how people goes to work in the morning from this town. 3.5 kilometers across the Volga River. And they demand you to wear masks here, you know? Ooh, fast. 5 meters a second it goes. And you see, because it's very cold weather now, it's minus like 12, this window covered in this frost. So you can't see that much maybe. Okay, now I need to take some pictures to send to my mom. It looks like mostly just a Soviet town, Soviet buildings, and here like local advertisements, what we can see here, like help to drug addicts, alcohol addicts, someone in a hard situation. Yeah, it's like mostly help to drug addicts, homeless people. Yeah, and a lot of babushkas here. And what can I say that about the city? I guess I'm still shy to film in public in Russia. But yeah, in this city, it's kind of people used to walk with beer, especially on Friday after work every day, like, you know, at night, like on the street. In St. Petersburg, I saw this when I was a kid, when I was like 10 years old or so. So you hardly ever see people drinking on the street, but here you still can see it. And even advertisement, you see it tries to help like people. Maybe it's a scam, but still. Of course, guys, Lenin here, some Soviet building, Soviet star, propaganda tower. Wow, guys, they exchange books here. It's crazy. Wow, this star. Soviet уголовный процесс book about criminal, but no English books. Wow, Mayakovsky. I am the citizen of the Soviet Union. Guys, but also I suggest you to use Yandex Maps, not Google Maps, because on Google Maps there is no even this cable car road shown. You know, use Yandex in Russia. It's a Russian company. And yeah, I hope, I want one of those girls' jumpers would jump while I am riding this cable car, oil ring, and it would be an epic, you know, scene. She's flying, guys, she's flying! Oh my god, I missed it. She was flying. Yes, she's flying again! Wow, but yeah, you can't really see, because they are actually, when I was a kid, I thought they are flying, you know, very high, but they are, we are starting shaking. Yeah, I need to take picture for my mom. So yeah, guys, that's how the university looks like in Nizhny Novgorod. Nizhny Novgorod government state. Technical University, and yeah, some Westerners, yeah, some students smoking there. Some many Westerners, they don't understand that education in Russia is free, and they say, oh, like how you can afford this education and so on. Wow, столовая. Столовая, I might need to go here to eat. Half of the students in Russia study for free, guys. That's like some kind of central part. But that's how buses looks like here. And I like it that they have this kind of old old like wooden houses as well. Yeah, Russian bus. What do you think of it when they mix old architecture with new one? That is actually the medical car. Institute of Military Transport. Yeah, guys, they produce guns in this city as well. There is like famous Almaz Antey factory here. It's Almaz Antey factory, Nizhny Novgorod one. We have few of them like in Moscow and St. Petersburg as well as, yeah. And they produce the protection rockets, air rockets, and in particular the famous one S-300, S-400, and now Russia even is developing the S-500, which we send even to Turkey now, and they are much better than American counterparts. So they protect our air, and you see they are made over here, and this is metro. Yeah, metro is not deep, but still it's enough to hide the peaceful sky is our profession. 1941-1945 monument again. Peaceful sky is our profession. You see, we, to make the sky peaceful against the West, we need to protect to make these rockets. I like their slogans. Here is written, profession for yourself, achievements for the fatherland. Yes, guys, and that's what I was saying. C-300, S-400, S-500 they produce here, you see? Well, and yeah, guys, this is the center of Nizhny Novgorod. They really made a good job when it was 800 years of Novgorod. Everything looks like very new, like Europe, you know. New bus stations here, but I like that they keep like Russian Soviet buses. It's pass, famous pass. Guys, this Western fashion of paid parking came even to Nizhny Novgorod. And it cost to park here near the Kremlin, guess how much, 60 rubles for 1 hour. So, the man from England is first time in Nizhny Novgorod, or? Второй, second time. What can you say about this city?
It's very beautiful, very snowy.
So yeah, this is the Kremlin. And guys, this city is famous that here Minin and Pozharsky organized the army to reconquer Moscow against the Polish occupants, and they were successful. We took out these Polish occupants. Wow, House of Soviets, Dom Soviet. Kremlin, guys. But here, guess what you have here? 1945 gun, Soviet guns, tank, the famous one, T-34, the most famous Soviet tank. ZS-2 57 millimeters guns. Yeah, Gorkovchanam for labor people here monument, because for Gorkovs, because in Soviet times the city also had different name, like St. Petersburg was Leningrad, but this city was called Gorky. Wow, they even have here the head of the submarine C-13. S-13. That's probably the famous Katyusha one. Rocket launcher. This. LA-7 also was produced by Gorky. Gorky Air Factory number 21. So yeah, actually they put here the weapons which were produced in this city to the motherland from Gorkov people, you know, Nizhny Novgorod people. I like it, you see? Soviet soldiers here. I wonder, was it like, what is it for? Maybe it was like bomb shelter here. Ah, yes, it's a shelter number 31, you see? Still saved here. Shelters. And by the way, yes, Nizhny Novgorod also has car sharing cars. You see one car sharing car, another car sharing car. In the West, as far as I know, there is no like car sharing or very small. But in Russia, if you, it's the biggest car sharing in the world after China, I guess. But you know, in China, it's 10 times bigger population. So in Russia, it's like per capita of people. It's the biggest in the world. I use it all the time. The modern bus stops are literally everywhere. For 800 years of Nizhny Novgorod, they put them. And yeah, let's check if people follow this. So this one is for glass, but people put here everything. This one is for plastic. Here at least some plastic I can see. And this is for aluminium. Aluminium like cans and stuff. No, yeah, at least something is right here, you see. Cans, aluminium cans, but here should be only glass, for example. So yeah, we are not Japanese people yet who would follow this. This is a World Cup stadium. Nizhny Novgorod, new stadium. Here was World Cup matches. It's actually on the river, located on the river. Yeah, but I'm lazy to walk there. Too much to walk. But yeah, you know what, honestly, stadium is not like that beautiful. It's in St. Petersburg the most beautiful stadium we have, like. Guys, I was quite surprised. I was thinking, where is the metro? Where is the metro? And it's like here. Like around nothing. And you see, it's very quiet. I mean, not even comparable with Moscow or St. Petersburg. No big traffic here, nothing. Guys, but even in this metro, there are so-called Germa doors, which doesn't let radiation go, and in case of the war we can close them. Every metro, yeah, you see this one, doors as well. very fat ones. So it metro 2033, you see, but even here. In St. Petersburg we have the same coins for metro, but without the hole in the middle. Maybe. I love the smell of metro. This is the central station where we're gonna change lines. They only have one change line. And here they have station like in New York. Guys, it's the first time in life I see the station. No, in Moscow they have similar few stations, but even in Moscow they don't look like that. It's like in New York type. But in New York it would be full of trash, you know, and rats. But here you see how clean it is here. Oh, бабушка and дедушка plays in metro. It's funny. I thought they punch a kid first. Oh my god, guys, it's warm. What's the cartoon they play here? I don't understand. It's crazy cartoon, guys. This is for feminists, you know. Not only men are the best specialists of Metropolitan. Here is Natalia, for example. And here is Olga. It's a lot of women, so you woke feminists, you see, in Russia, Елена. We respect women in Russia. Татьяна. And there are two women. Yeah. Wow, it's crazy. I want to go there so much, but...
Mind the closing doors. The next station is Burnokhodskaya.
Guys.
Mind the closing doors.
I don't show you the stations only shortly because it's not St. Petersburg or Moscow, so you have to wait for the train like 8, 7, 10 minutes. Yeah, it's like New York, like in New York type stations here. Guys, woman clean up the territory, you see? Very nice. And I don't think she's working here or something, but she removes this cigarette end switch. Pigs littering. So respect to this woman. guys, it's the record snowing in this city this year, and look what I found, self-made mountain for kids to ride here. And you know what, this city is actually pretty clean. Of course, snow can cover some old trash, and in spring it can be a different story, but yeah, I like the trash is changing. When I was a kid, cities, like, people littered much more than nowadays. And yeah, you know, this neighborhood actually is pretty safe. City is very polite people compared to Moscow, for example. Even those drunks who I met near the shop, they were very polite to me. Yeah, and I recommend you to visit and subscribe to my channel and for the next Soviet adventure.